You might think, why do we need such a volumetric truck mixer when we have drum mixers all over the city? The main difference between these two is basically, in a drum mixer, the concrete is already pre-batched, pre-mixed basically, and your time is ticking. You have 2 hours to reach your destination, otherwise it might spoil. With a concrete, with a volumetric truck mixer, you are transporting the raw ingredients, the raw material to the site, and start mixing when you want, wherever you want. This is the main difference between these two technologies. You might say, okay, why do we need this in a development area like Jakarta? Jakarta, we have plenty of existing batching plants all over, so we have a wide range and coverage of concrete. We see the supply radius of each plant, approximately 2 hours driving. You see overlapping where you can choose as I go for batching plant A or batching plant B. So for a developed area like this, with a high amount of existing concrete batching plants, you would not necessarily need a fully automatic or mobile batching plant. But what happens if you're talking about more remote areas, for example in Lombok? We have our capital Mataram, and we have a smaller amount of existing batching plants over there. Each batching plant, of course, has the same radius of 2 hour driving basically, and you can cover these regions. But what about the rest of the island? What about Kuta in the south? What about the Gili Islands in the north? What about the harbor areas on the far east side? These areas are out of the existing radius of batching plants. Depending on the size of your project, you have to evaluate, is it worth of transporting a batching plant to the site? And if you required concrete is less basically than the project minimum for the feasible cost, then you would probably not do this, and you would start using a hand drum mixer, and then again it takes ages and ages and ages. When it comes to the volumetric truck mixers, you have full control of your deliveries. You are completely in charge of where it is delivered and when it is delivered. You are not depending on any existing batching plant. I know a lot of companies having kind of always this risk in the head of their mind, like, oh, what happens if there's a breakdown of the batching plant? If they have unscheduled maintenance or whatever, then you just don't get concrete in time. So you're always depending on third parties, always on others. What happens when you start your project and you have a massive rainfall? Usually you have to stop your production outside. You can't basically build anything in a massive pouring rain, so you have to wait. If it's more than 2 hours again, your batch is gone and you have to dump it. But still you have to pay full amount, so it's a waste of time and waste of your cost. Full control of your concrete mixing. There is no minimum batch requirement basically. When it comes to smaller repair works, you don't have to get a full concrete drum mixer of 8 cubic. You just mix the amount of what you need, 5 cubic, 3 cubic, easy as that, and then continue to the next small construction site. Even if there are different recipes required, either with additional additives or with an additional color of your concrete, you just simply modify the mixing, start pouring, and you just produce the amount of concrete what you want. The mixing is right next to the truck or right behind the truck, and you have a full control. You see what is mixed, you see how the concrete looks like, and you always have the chance to interfere in case something is not according to the plan. You have full control of your logistics. In meaning, you reach remote areas on time. You know, Jakarta has a lot of traffic issues, and when you order concrete, oh, can I make it on time? Will I be stuck in traffic? Doesn't bother you anymore. You just drive, when you arrive, you start mixing, and the 2 hour time of concrete is not ticking for you. When it comes to the mixing quality, we have, as I mentioned, a visual control behind the truck. All the mixing stages are protocoled and reported, so you have full control of the amount of material you are used, the quantity and the volume for your time, for your batch basically, and it's a full traceability. There is no funny shortage end of the week or end of the day where material goes missing. And it's a full consistent quality of mixing. What often happens is under or over ordering of concrete of an end customer. So if an end customer under orders for Paveway, for example, for his garage, then you can't finish the project. Certain projects can be added on top with additional truck mix on the following day. Some others have to be demolished because it has to be one full structure in one go. So it is always an issue of under or over ordering. If you over order, of course you still have to pay for this and you have to dump it end of the day. When it comes to concrete, there is also no excess of concrete end of the day. Whenever 6 o'clock, end of your shift basically, you stop the mixer with the leftover raw materials on the truck. You don't have to use them, you just use them the next day. It all remains separately on the truck. You don't have to use it, you don't have wastage, you save money for this. You don't have to pay for leftovers. And how does it actually work? How does a volumetric truck work? It's basically explained in 6 simple steps. We have, first of all, the loading of a truck. Each raw material is individually loaded and stored in separate compartments. Of course, can be equipped with any kind of liquid, any kind of additives as well, and all separately. When it comes to the mixing design and adjusting of the recipe, it's easily done, easily modified, easily adjusted to the right amount of sand, right amount of coarse material, water and cement. You can produce any kind of concrete with this one, either if it's rapid set concrete, flowable fill, doesn't matter, you just simply adjust your settings basically and start pouring the amount of what you need. Operating of the machine is in the rear of the truck, where the operator has full control of what is happening. He sees the flow of the concrete, he sees the volume which is coming out, he sees the quality or the density of the concrete, either if it's too watery or too hard basically. He can easily simply adjust it. And transportation is basically gravity loader system, cement. The sand and aggregates dropping down on a conveyor belt will be pulled out to the rear, simply and easily transported. And in the rear is the mixing, is an auger, where you have the volumetric mixing. It's a continuous mixing process which guarantees a homogenized product for you, which is most important, continuous quality, continuous concrete. And of course, placing the concrete can be either with a chute to the correct position, you can adjust it, play around with the angle to where you need, or in case you're working with a concrete pump, to either go to a higher level, also just pour it into a concrete pump, equal to a concrete drum mix. We were talking about truck mixers all the time, but it's not only necessary a truck mixer, it can also be mounted on a trailer, parked somewhere remotely, or on a railway when it comes to tunneling or mining projects, also widely common. And for precast, for example, can be stationary mounted, where you just move it around, place it more permanently in one area, so you don't have the cost. So there's a running cost for any kind of truck or other vehicles around if you intend to use it in one location mainly. Here I can give you one example. A friend of mine is having a precast factory, and in fact he had a certain growth over the last few years, and now he has 3 precast plants. In each plant, he's running a different product. Plant A, he has tunnelings and piping product. In plant B, he has piles and pillars, basically. And in plant C, he's running various projects, basically customized and special projects. Whenever there's a tender, he's of course applying, and if he wins a tender, he has a higher demand. He usually set up his production line based on his weekly and monthly production, but if he gets additional orders in, he has a higher demand. So he has 2 choices. Either he goes for plant number 4, which is of course a high investment of money, of logistics overall, and area, all the running costs around. So what he did, he went for a volumetric mixer. He is basically driving around with his volumetric mixer from plant A to plant B, wherever is the higher amount of demand for your concrete. You can support again your production with additional 45 cubic meters per hour. Usual production plant of what he has is like 60 cubic meters with additional 45. It's almost 75% additional production capacity on top to his usual business. He has the advantage of using all the available infrastructure for his logistics. All the aggregate placement, the equipment for loading, reload and everything is anyway available on his site. So he's basically just adding additional concrete mixing power to this one with no running cost. Precast is only one example where you can use it. Another example, another common example is for repair works. When you have a stretch of a pavement of a road, another 50 meters here, and a different road, another 100 meters here, you would not usually need a full 8 cubic meter drum mixer to fix it. And even if you need more than one drum mixer, you have to get a second one, which is only half use basically, and you still have to pay full amount for this one, and afterwards dump your concrete. So for these applications, you produce just the amount of concrete of what you need, no leftovers, no limitations, and minimum purchase basically of concrete of a full truckload, and just the usage what it is. It is often used for repair works on airways, so on airports, since it's easy to reach, flexible to reach, you're not interfering with the transportation of planes. It's used for railroads as well as for residential areas, tunnels, and of course especially for remote areas. Thank you very much.